Todo me acordé. Gracias, gracias a usted. Gracias. Ok, gracias, Maya. Como siempre me acuerdan, le vamos a dar un punto extra en el examen final. Okay. Now, people, very good. Ok. Ok, where do platypus dig their tunnel? Where do platypus guys is an animal? Ok, what is a platypus teacher? Teacher, what is a platypus? Ok, ¿quién nos dijo ayer que era un platypus? ¿Se acuerdan? Ya se les olvidó a ustedes. Está ahí el compañero que nos dijo platypus.
Ornitorrinco.
Yes, ¿y qué es un ornitorrinco? Vaya usted a
It's
saber,
an
teacher.
animal.
We don't know. Yeah, but what kind of animal it is? That's the
It's a
difficult
mammal.
question to answer. What?
It's a
That is,
mammal.
guys, that is the difficult question to answer. Okay. Are they mammals? Okay. Are there birds? Okay, guys. That's the question that you have to answer, people. Okay. I have here, guys. I'm going to paste, guys, a little picture here.
This is
That's a.
Perry the
I'm sorry.
Perry
Platypus.
the Platinum. Yes.
Yes. Okay, guys, I am going to paste here, guys, a picture of the animal. Okay, that's for you guys. Okay, my goodness, what's happening here? What's happening here? Wait a minute, guys. So I'm going to paste it here. Wait a minute, guys. Okay, here we go. Yes, now that's much more better. This is a platypus, guys. Okay, this is a platypus. And now, guys, okay, it's video time. Okay. And we have to practice, guys, listening, listening, okay. Esta es la mejor manera de mejorar la habilidad auditiva. Teacher, no entiendo. Vea el video 100 veces, okay. Así nos hizo un profesor. Ahí les voy a contar un chamber más adelante. So, guys, what was formed by raising temperatures? What happened, guys? That is 10, right? What was formed by raising temperatures? What happened, guys? You see? When temperatures increased, but you have to tell me what happened on planet Earth, specifically, guys, in this place, which is where we are talking about. Okay, guys, are you ready to watch a video now? Please, you might want to copy these questions, guys. So please copy these questions into your notebook, people. Please do me the favor, vaya, copien las preguntas en el cuaderno antes de que empecemos. And then, guys, get ready to rumble, people. Get ready to rumble. Okay, guys, please copy this, and then I am going to play the video for you all, people. Okay? It's an interesting animal, guys. That's why I decided to look for the video. Yeah, I said to myself, that's an interesting animal. Teacher, where are the directions? Yes. Answer the questions based, okay, on the, wait a minute, based on the, my goodness, information you get from the video. Yes, that's what it is, people. That's what it is. You tell me when you're ready, guys. Okay, you tell me when you're ready. You tell me when you would like me to play the video, right? What is the video about? Platypus are from, they live in El Salvador, teacher. Platypus are, okay, are they reptiles, mammals? What is it that they are? Okay. What diet do platypus have? That means, guys, what do they eat? What is the platypus habitat? That means, guys, where do they live? In trees, in mountains, in lakes? You have to tell me where they live. What are the competitors of platypus? Okay. What species of platypus belong to? Okay, it's like a subcategory, guys. You see, it's like a set within another set. When the aborigines arrived in Australia, okay, where the platypus dig their tunnels, what was formed, guys, by raising temperatures? Okay. Why do I have such a bad memory? Claro, me voy a poner esto. Miren, aquí está el rótulo. Miren lo que les digo. Lo ven. Record the class. Lo tengo aquí enfrente y se me olvida. Okay. How come I forget it? Lo voy a poner aquí enfrente, amigo. Aquí lo voy a poner enfrente. Okay. A ver si me funciona el cerebro una vez en la vida. Okay. I hate my brain. Odio mi Parkinson. I hate my Parkinson. Okay, people, do I play the video now, guys? Do I play the video now, guys? Did you copy all the questions already? Hoy no
Yes.
podré participar, me duele la garganta. No hay problema, Melvin. No hay problema, Melvin. Okay. Anda al doctor, Melvin. Okay. Una buena, sí, mira, eucalipto. Okay. Eucalipto dicen que ayuda bastante. Okay, guys, everybody. Solo alguien me dijo sí. What about the rest of the class, guys? Is there somebody else who needs more time? ¿Habrá alguien más que necesita más tiempo? Or shall we rock and roll right now? Do we rock and roll right now, people? Let us rock and roll. Yes, people? People, say something. Digan algo ustedes, no me ignoren.
Yes,
Freddy.
Don't go breaking my heart. Okay, don't go breaking my heart. Okay, people, here we go. And let me play the video for you guys. Okay. Welcome to our party, guys, okay? This is DJ Teacher Flores, playing very, very old music, okay? Okay, taking you back in time, guys, okay? Taking you back, okay, to the 70s, guys, and the 80s, okay? Wait a minute, guys, now I have to make a technical adjustment here so that you guys listen to the audio, right? Let me make a technical adjustment. 1, 2, 3.
Today in the entire world, there are only three existing species of these archaic mammals that lay eggs. Two of them are echidnas, the long-snouted variety in New Guinea, and this one, the short-snouted variety, which can be found throughout Australia. The third member of the family is the strangest mammal known to man, the duck-billed platypus, a shy animal which lives in some rivers in the east of Australia. The rivers of Australia were no exception in the parallel evolution which has taken place over the 50 million years that Australia has been traveling alone across the Indian Ocean. Fish and invertebrates acquired new forms, some of them as strange as the Neoceratodus, the Australian lunged fish whose origins go back to the Devonian era, approximately 350 million years ago. But the most extraordinary creature now living in the rivers of Australia originally developed on land. The duck-billed platypus looks like an impossible compendium of different zoological types. From the time Dawson sent his controversial sample to the British Natural History Museum, there were constant scientific discussions, lasting for over 100 years, until finally two zoologists demonstrated irrefutably that they were indeed mammals. And reproduced by laying eggs. Although they are small in size, the duck-billed platypuses would seem to have an insatiable appetite. This one has found a river crab, crustacean, mollusks, annelids, and even amphibians form part of their extremely varied diet. And their peculiar morphology means they are able to hunt their prey even in muddy waters. Using its webbed feet and broad muscular tail to propel itself along, the archaic platypus searches the river bottom. The sensors on its beak detect the slightest movement or change in temperature. Any animal crawling or swimming along the riverbed is rapidly located and, if it is of any interest, devoured. In the rivers of Australia, the platypus is so well adapted it has no competitors, or rather, almost none. As in so many other environmental niches, the placentary mammals have also come up with a prototype. On this occasion, the result of the evolutionary process was the water rat or beaver rat, which was able to thrive in the aquatic world thanks to its waterproof fur and partially webbed feet. Strangely, no marsupial tried to colonize the rivers of Australia, and so the freshwater resources of this continent are shared between the modern water rat and the archaic duck-billed platypus. The Aborigines who arrived in Australia 50,000 years ago already knew the duck-billed platypus, which they named the water mole, a very appropriate name given that the platypus lives out its amphibious life between the water, where it finds food, and the riverbanks, where it digs its tunnels. Their dependence on the rivers, however, limited the spread of the saliva from Gondwana. Because as Australia became increasingly dry, as the rivers of the interior slowly disappeared with the rise in temperatures, deserts were formed. Today, in the entire world, there are only three existing species of these archaic mammals that lay eggs. Two of them are echidnas, the long-snouted variety in New Guinea, and this one, the short-snouted variety, which can be found throughout Australia. The third member of the family is the strangest mammal known to man, the duck-billed platypus, a shy animal which lives in some rivers in the east of Australia. The rivers of Australia were no exception in the parallel evolution which has taken place over the 50 million years that Australia has been travelling alone across the Indian Ocean. Fish and invertebrates acquired new forms, some of them as strange as the Neoceratodus, the Australian lunged fish whose origins go back to the Devonian era, approximately 350 million years ago. But the most extraordinary creature now living in the rivers of Australia originally developed on land. The duck-billed platypus looks like an impossible compendium of different zoological types. From the time Dawson sent his controversial sample to the British Natural History Museum, there were constant scientific discussions, lasting for over 100 years, until finally two zoologists demonstrated irrefutably that they were indeed mammals and reproduced by laying eggs. Although they are small in size, the duck-billed platypuses would seem to have an insatiable appetite. This one has found a river crab. Crustaceans, mollusks, annelids, and even amphibians form part of their extremely varied diet. And their peculiar morphology means they are able to hunt their prey even in muddy waters. Using its webbed feet and broad muscular tail to propel itself along, the archaic platypus searches the river bottom. The sensors on its beak detect the slightest movement or change in temperature. Any animal crawling or swimming along the riverbed is rapidly located, and if it is of any interest, devoured. In the rivers of Australia, the platypus is so well adapted, it has no competitors, or rather, almost none. As in so many other environmental niches, the placentary mammals have also come up with a prototype. On this occasion, the result of the evolutionary process was the water rat or beaver rat, which was able to thrive in the aquatic world thanks to its waterproof fur and partially webbed feet. Strangely, no marsupial tried to colonize the rivers of Australia, and so the freshwater resources of this continent are shared between the modern water rat and the archaic duck-billed platypus. The Aborigines who arrived in Australia 50,000 years ago already knew the duck-billed platypus, which they named the water mole. A very appropriate name, given that the platypus lives out its amphibious life between the water, where it finds food, and the riverbanks, where it digs its tunnels. Their dependence on the rivers, however, limited the spread of the survivor from Gondwana, because as Australia became increasingly dry, as the rivers of the interior slowly disappeared with the rise in temperatures, deserts were formed.
One, two, three, testing, testing, testing. Do you hear me, guys? Do you hear me now? People, do you hear me? No. People, do you hear
me?
Yes, okay, thank you, thank you.
Yes.
Remember, guys, that I need your, you know, your feedback, guys, just in order to know if this thing is working well or not. Okay, guys, now let's go back to the questionnaire. Okay, this is our beautiful friend. This is our, you know, strange friend. Yeah, this is our buddy, the platypus. Okay, guys, so we begin right here, guys. Okay, first question, what is the video about, guys? The video is about a friendly buddy, okay, whose name is? Yes, what is the video about, people? Number one?
Platypus.
Yes, it is about, guys, the platypus. You see? Wonderful, guys. You see, guys? Very good. Number two, guys. Okay, platypus are from El Salvador, the United States, Europe, Japan, China. Where are they from, guys?
East of Australia.
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 Yeah, wonderful people, wonderful, yes. Okay, guys, now let's continue, guys. Okay, platypus are, guys, when in terms of the animal kingdom, guys, what category do they belong to?
It's mammals.
Yes, they are mammals, very good. Mammals, you see, which means, guys, that they suck milk. Lo que significa que ellos, al igual que nosotros los humanos, también toman leche, you see. Okay, they suck milk when they are offspring, you see. Cuando están recién nacidos, como nosotros también, toman leche. Okay, what diet do platypus have, guys? What do they eat, guys?
Crabs, crustaceans,
mollusks. So, guys, they have a varied diet, okay? Mostly, guys, they eat other little animals, you see? You see, guys? Very good. You got it. Crabs, mollusks, okay? And other animals that live, guys, in their habitat, right? What is the platypus habitat, guys? Where do they live?
The river.
Rivers.
The rivers, pretty much, guys. River, okay? The rivers. They say, guys, mostly, the place where they find their food, guys, it is riverbed. Ahí está. Y que los grillos tienen cama, teacher. Riverbed es como el fondo del río. El fondo del río. Okay, riverbed. Now, what are the competitors of the platypus, guys? Los que le quitan la comida. Well, they are the only animals, the only mammals, guys, that they live in rivers in Australia. Yes, I'm sorry. What was that? Mireya?
Rat. No me confundí.
Yes, it was a rat. A rat. Okay. Sí, así. Pero ellos dijeron, miren. Water rat. Pero, teacher, ellos no dijeron water rat. Tiene razón. No es un inglés gringo, ¿verdad? Es de water rat, algo así como water rat. Entonces era un inglés más británico, ¿verdad? Water rat, ¿ok?
Water rat.
Yeah, something, water rat. Pass me the water, ¿ok? Pass me the water. I'm thirsty, ¿ok? I'm thirsty. Thank you, don't mention it, ¿ok? What species do platypus belong to, guys? What species do they belong to, people? Miren, yo al principio, y por eso puse esta pregunta, pensé que eran marsupials. Marsupials. Eso significa que los hacían familiares de los canguros. Pero no son marsupials. Entonces aquí de nuevo vamos a decir mammals. Okay, mammals. So we'll say one more time, guys. Mammals. When did aborigines arrive in Australia? And I was making pauses, guys. I don't know if you noticed this. The first time I played the video, yo hacía pausas. I was making like pauses. So when did aborigines, guys, arrive in Australia? How long ago? That is the question. How long ago? Yes, people? When did they come? It is a multiple of 5. Un múltiplo de 5. Uh-huh. 50, teacher. 500, teacher. Higher. 500. 50. Yes. 50 what? 50 tomatoes. 50 potatoes. 50 what? Yes. 50 what? 50. Vaya, leanme estos pedacitos. I'm sorry. Say it again. 50.
Million years.
Yeah. 50. Vamos, quiero oír esos tres ceritos. ¿Cómo se dicen esos tres ceros? Yeah, 50,000 years ago. Okay. Where do platypus, guys, okay, dig their tunnels? Yeah, guys? Where do they dig their tunnels? Which is their houses, right? Their mansions, guys, the places where they live. Where do they dig them?
For life, for live.
I'm sorry?
For live.
You mean in rivers? Yeah, but it is more specific. It's a place where you go get money, guys. It's a place where you go and you get money when you are broke. When you need money, where do you go, guys? Where do you go when you need money, people? Where is the... Yes, guys, where do you go if you need money? If you need to pay your bills, where do you go?
At the bank.
So, guys, teacher, no me diga que viven en los bancos. They dig their tunnels, guys, in riverbanks. Riverbanks. No sé cómo traducirlo ahorita, para serle sincero, pero es una parte del río. Es una parte del río. No sé cómo traducirlo ahorita. They build their tunnels in riverbanks. Okay, yo pienso que quizás es esa parte donde los ríos salen. No sé, I don't know. Okay. We have to find it out. We have to find out the equivalent. Tenemos que investigar el equivalente. Okay, what's formed by raising temperatures? Okay, guys? What was formed by raising temperatures, people? By raising temperatures, guys? People? Guys, the answer is deserts. Deserts. Okay, veamos, puntuación. Okay, para el teacher. No, este es de ustedes, ustedes la contestaron. Okay, platypals are from, para el teacher. No, esta ustedes la contestaron. Platypals are, esta ustedes la contestaron. This was your answer, guys, not mine. Okay, what diet do platypals have? That's yours, guys, that's your. Where do platypals live? This is mine. Esta sí yo la contesté. Okay, what are the competitors of platypus? Okay, this one is yours, guys. Esa ustedes la contestaron. What species the platypus belong to? Bueno, este es del teacher, digamos, del teacher. Okay, when did aborigines arrive in Australia? Y alguien por ahí me dijo 50. Esa es de ustedes. Where do platypus dig tunnels? That's for the teacher, guys. Okay, what was formed by raising temperatures? That was also the teacher, guys. Okay, let us read. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, 6 guys out of 10, yes, very good, very good, les dije 5, miren, y lo subestimé, contestaron 6, ¿verdad? Ahora, yo creo que si les pongo el video una vez más, hoy sí lo van a entender más, entonces esa es la idea, ¿verdad? But before that, guys, I want you to repeat after me, so everybody please turn on your microphones and repeat after me. Platypus. Go ahead, guys. Repeat.
Platypus.
Okay. East Australia. Go ahead, guys. Repeat. East
Australia. East Australia. East Australia.
Mammals. Mammals.
Mammals.
Okay. Here we go, guys. Varied diet. Varied diet. Go ahead.
Varied diet.
Okay, people. Now repeat after me. Riverbed. Está para que le entiendan así como la dicen en el video, ponle un acento británico. Water rat. Okay. Y para que entiendan esto en el video, repeat after me. Marsupials. Okay, guys. Now, 50,000 years ago.
50,000 years ago.
Riverbanks. Okay.
Riverbank.
Me imagino que leo esto de Riverbanks y me imagino ahí al platypus saliendo del banco con la tarjeta de que acaba de sacar pisto de los cajeros, ¿verdad? Okay, guys, please repeat after me. Deserts. Veamos el video una vez más y les aseguro que hoy sí lo van a entender. Para los que no lo
entienden.
Yes, tell me.
Quería comentarle que mi compañera Stephanie Cañas me dijo que este día no podría estar en la clase porque iba a llevar a su abuelita a la clínica y que le había enviado un correo a su...
Sí, es verdad. Sí. Cuando pase la asistencia, me acuerdo, sí, me mandó un correo, pero a mí se me olvidan los nombres, así que, por favor, me
vaya, está bien.
Please remind me. Thank you. Thanks so much. Okay, now, guys, you will see that you will now understand the video, guys. Ya van a ver que hoy sí lo van a entender. Now, it's going to be a lot much more better and easier for you guys to understand it, right? Here we go. Here we go. Okay, let me make guys a technical adjustment here so that you listen guys to the audio of the video, guys.
Today in the entire world, there are only three existing species of these archaic mammals that lay eggs. Two of them are echidnas, the long-snouted variety in New Guinea, and this one, the short-snouted variety, which can be found throughout Australia. The third member of the family is the strangest mammal known to man, the duck-billed platypus, a shy animal which lives in some rivers in the east of Australia. rivers of Australia were no exception in the parallel evolution which has taken place over the 50 million years that Australia has been traveling alone across the Indian Ocean. Fish and invertebrates acquired new forms, some of them as strange as the Neoceratodus, the Australian lunged fish whose origins go back to the Devonian era, approximately 350 million years ago. But the most extraordinary creature now living in the rivers of Australia originally developed on land. The duckbill platypus looks like an impossible compendium of different zoological types. From the time Dawson sent his controversial sample to the British Natural History Museum, there were constant scientific discussions, lasting for over 100 years, until finally two zoologists demonstrated irrefutably that they were indeed mammals and reproduced by laying eggs. Although they are small in size, the duckbill platypuses would seem to have an insatiable appetite. This one has found a river crab. Crustaceans, mollusks, annelids, and even amphibians form part of their extremely varied diet. And their peculiar morphology means they are able to hunt their prey even in muddy waters. Using its webbed feet and broad muscular tail to propel itself along, the archaic platypus searches the river bottom. The sensors on its beak detect the slightest movement or change in temperature. Any animal crawling or swimming along the riverbed is rapidly located and, if it is of any interest, devoured. In the rivers of Australia, the platypus is so well adapted it has no competitors, or rather, almost none. As in so many other environmental niches, the placentary mammals have also come up with a prototype. On this occasion, the result of the evolutionary process was the water rat or beaver rat, which was able to thrive in the aquatic world thanks to its waterproof fur and partially webbed feet. Strangely, no marsupial try to colonize the rivers of Australia, and so the freshwater resources of this continent are shared between the modern water rat and the archaic duck-billed platypus. The Aborigines who arrived in Australia 50,000 years ago already knew the duck-billed platypus, which they named the water mole, a very appropriate name given that the platypus lives out its amphibious life between the water, where it finds food, and the riverbanks, where it digs its tunnels. Their dependence on the rivers, however, limited the spread of the survivor from Gondwana. Because as Australia became increasingly dry, as the rivers of the interior slowly disappeared with the rise in temperatures, deserts were formed.
Wonderful. That was wonderful. Did you like the video, guys? Did you understand it better? ¿Lo entendieron mejor?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Es un proceso, ¿verdad? De primero los pongo a oír, después trabajamos el vocabulario, y ya cuando hemos trabajado el vocabulario, lo oímos de nuevo, y ya le hemos sacado más filo al oído. So, you see, guys, it's a process that we have to follow. Okay, first we watch the video, then, guys, we work on the vocabulary, and then, guys, we watch it again, and you sharpen your ears. Okay, guys? Wonderful. Congratulations, okay? Lo felicito porque ese era un nivel avanzado de inglés, okay? Quiere decir que tiene un gran potencial. Los felicito a todos. Okay, people, now let's work on the book. Let's work on the book, guys. Let us work on the book. Okay, guys. Let's continue advancing in the book, guys. Wait a minute. Where is the book? Oh yeah, I think I pushed the click on the wrong, you know, icon. Yes, here it is, guys. But guys, yesterday I think I forgot to check attendance, guys. So I'm going to check attendance right now because I don't want to forget it, guys. Yesterday, guys, I think I forgot it. Okay, yes, it will be those. Okay, so we will do it right now. Wait a minute. Okay. Did I do it yesterday? No, yesterday I did. In the evening is that I forgot. So, guys, it is. Wait a minute, I'm confused. What was the date yesterday, guys? Oh, yeah, yesterday was 23rd, right? Wait a minute. 22. Yes, here it is. 23rd. Okay, guys. So, today is February the 24th, guys. We are on February, guys. The 24th, and the year, guys, is 2021, right? Okay, I'm getting the date written here, people. Now I say your names, guys, and you say present, right? Which is what we always do. Blanca Idalia? Blanca?
Present. Blanca?
Okay.
Hi.
Hello, good morning. Gracias, Maria.
Present.
Gracias, Maria. Okay. Miriam Arely?
Present, teacher.
Okay, very good. Monica Guadalupe? Monica? Oh, okay.
Present, teacher.
Okay, you're Monica. Very good. Mayra Yanet?
Present, teacher.
Juan Diego? Juan?
Present, teacher.
Okay. Fabricio Alberto? Guys, and Fabricio is not in the class today. Okay, Ana Emilia? Ana? Okay.
She has a shift.
A shift? What do you mean by a shift? What is that?
Medical
shift. The schedule. Oh, yeah. Okay, I changed the schedule. Okay, very good, very good. Tell her, please, to watch the video. Vale. Le vamos a poner aquí una asistencia. Dígale que vea el video, por favor.
Yes.
Is she your classmate? Is she your co-worker? Hola? ¿Cómo? Oh, alguien. Somebody's trying to enter. Déjame ver. No. ¿Qué fue lo que dijiste, Gitalo? Perdón.
Como ya le tomó asistencia a Fabricio Alberto, él ya está dentro del grupo de nuevo.
Okay. Ah, well, let me check. Okay. Fabricio, are you in the class?
Yes,
okay, I'll trust you. Okay. Mira, ¿y qué pasó ayer? ¿No estuviste en la clase, Fabricio?
No pude venir, no pude entrar porque siempre a veces salgo temprano, más temprano lo
pongo. ¿Y ya viste el video? Ah, sí, vos me escribiste al Facebook, ¿verdad? Va, ve el video, Fabricio. Ve el video. Va. Guys, María Clelia. María.
Good morning, teacher, present.
Okay. Stephanie, bueno, ya me dijeron que anda con la abuela. Hazel Marjorie.
Present.
Marjorie. Okay, good. Jennifer Samara.
Present.
Yesenia Arling. Yesenia. She's not in the class. Arling Beatriz. Yo me acuerdo que vi a Arling que estaba por ahí ustedes. I remember that I saw her like somewhere. Arling, where are you? Let me check, guys. Yes, ahí está. Why don't you answer me? ¿Por qué no me contesta Arlene? No me ignore, Arlene. Okay, Miriam, Noemi. Miriam.
Present.
¿Qué le pasó ayer, Miriam? ¿No estuvo en la clase?
No, lo que pasa es que estoy enferma. Ajá. Y amanecí mal.
Está bien, no se preocupe.
Gracias.
Okay. Mireia Carolina, yo le pongo asistencia, ve el video. Mireia Carolina.
Present.
Okay, very good. Yeah, aquí le voy a poner un asterisco, punto extra por recordarme de grabar la clase. Okay, Melvin Steven. Melvin. Okay, you're welcome. Melvin Steven. Melvin. Se durmió Melvin ahora. Rodrigo Alejandro.
Present. Rodrigo.
Okay, good. Carla Verónica.
Hi, Carla. Teacher.
Hello, what's up? Susie Annette. Yes, Melvin, that's Melvin.
Le por había ahí escrito creo que me dolía la garganta
ah,
y
vaya,
creo
vaya,
que
vaya,
no
ya
lo
no
vi
digas nada. Sí, yo sé, yo está, ahí te oigo todo enfermo, no te preocupes, ya te puse este disco. Susi, Anat, ya no digas nada, me digo que están bien enfermos. Susi, Anat.
Hello, I am here.
Hello, ok, very good. Ítalo, no diga nada, que sé que está enfermo, pero ya sé que está por ahí. Tatiana, Stephanie.
Present.
Ok, very good, guys. Guys, everybody's getting sick. How can that be? Todos están enfermando. Ok, cuídense mucho. Ok, vayan al médico. Ok. Y las resinas, las medicinas herbarias a veces funcionan. No, no las subestiman, ¿verdad? Ok. Guys, now let's work on the book, people. Are you seeing the book right now, guys? Are you seeing the book? People? Do you see the book, people?
Not yet.
Ok, let me present it here then.
Ah, teacher, una pregunta.
Yes.
Nunca me menciona cuando pasa lista.
Y cuando te... Pero no me hubieras dicho, Emerson. ¿Y cuándo te inscribiste, Emerson? ¿O cuándo empezaste a asistir clases?
Empecé este lunes que pasó.
Por eso. Y no me habías dicho nada, Emerson.
No se me había olvidado decirle, teacher.
Emerson, te vamos a dar la oreja, Emerson. Lo que tengo aquí... Espérame. Ítalo, Susi. Déjame buscar tu nombre. Tatiana, Ítalo, okay. Susi, Carla, Rodrigo, Melvin, Mireia, Miriam, Arlene, Yesenia, Jennifer, Hazel, Stephanie, María, Fabricio, Mayra, Mónica. Sí, no estás en la lista. No estás en la lista. Me hubieras dicho. Ok, espérame. Wait for me. Ok, wait. Give me a second. And what is your name, my friend? Emerson Aníbal, your complete name?
Hernández Romero.
Emerson Aníbal, ok. ¿Y qué tal estás ya para el examen?
Yo me siento preparado.
Ok, ah, bueno, te has preparado. Entonces, ¿sí saben de qué se trata? Esa es la pregunta. Vale, entonces, ¿saben de qué se trata? Vale, excelente. Vale, es lo que quería saber. Vale, te voy a poner asistencia lunes, martes y miércoles. ¿Y ya viste los videos de la semana pasada?
Sí, ya los vi.
Va, venlos y ponete al día, ¿verdad? Ya sabes cuáles son las tareas que hay que hacer y todo lo demás, plataforma y todo lo demás.
Sí, por cierto, ayer le mandé la evaluación que tuvimos, pero mi duda era si teníamos que mandárselo al correo institucional de usted.
Necesito el correo institucional, nombre completo, horario y nivel para no confundirme, porque acuérdense que les he asignado tareas a todos los niveles, ¿ok?
Okay, teacher.
Emerson, y ya te mandé la invitación en el Google Classroom. ¿Estás en el Google Classroom, Emerson?
Sí, ahí estoy.
Ok, very good. That's what I wanted to know. Okay, wonderful. Bueno, y no tenés problemas con el link, ¿verdad? El link de la clase es siempre el mismo.
Sí, siempre el mismo. No tengo problemas.
Good. Thank you, my friend. Guys, if anything comes up, please, guys, let me know. Por favor, cualquier cosa, díganme, porque acuérdense que yo tengo que pasar las notas y todo esto al sistema. Y si no me dicen nada, después no. Se van a quedar sin nota ustedes. Cualquier cosa, díganme. Please, people, tell me. Please, tell me now. What band was that one, guys? Please tell me now. Duran, guys. Duran. Okay, here we go, guys. Open your books, people. Yes. Unit 2, Big Happy Family. What is it that we're talking about, guys? We're talking about your family, guys. Your family. Your big, big Salvadorian family, guys. You see, this is what we did yesterday. Do you remember, guys? Conversation, first meeting, okay? Okay. You see, guys, this is where we stopped yesterday. Also, we did, I believe, guys, these exercises. Okay, boyfriend, by the way, thirsty, guys. Also, okay, we did this exercise. Do you remember? And here's where we finished yesterday, guys, with this listening exercise, guys. Okay, now, guys, this is something that you know now, okay, and that I understand. You are experts, you see, guys, at using the possessive. So this is what we have to review now, guys, okay? Possessive nouns, guys. Singular. he's my uncle's dog. Okay. Ruth's last name is Hanks. Okay. Plural. The girl's parents are both teachers. The man's clothes are on sale. So, guys, okay, if a word doesn't have an N, what do we do at the end? We place an apostrophe. And also, guys, we add, you see, an S to the end. But, guys, if the word, the noun, is pluralized, and that means that it has an S at the end, like girls, what do? We only have to place, guys, an apostrophe. An apostrophe. You see, guys? You see? Now, guys, if it ends in TH, we add an apostrophe and letter S. Okay? If it ends in another consonant, like man, you only add, guys, an apostrophe and an S to the end. Do you understand, guys? ¿Entienden la idea? ¿Entienden la idea? Que si termina en S, solo le agregamos el apóstrofe. Pero si termina en vocal o cualquier otra consonante, le agregamos el apóstrofe y la S. Okay, guys, I hope that's clear, okay? Possessive adjectives, guys. This is what we studied last time, you remember? Subject pronouns, I, you, she, he, it, we, they. Possessive adjectives, guys. My, your, her, his, its, our, their, okay? Possessive pronouns, mine, yours, hers, his, ours, theirs. And what about this one? Okay. What about this one? I would say it's here. Okay. Usage note. Don't confuse it's. Okay. That is the contraction of the subject pronoun it and the verb to be with it's. It's means it is. See the example below. It's a nice car. The house has its own garage. For example, here's my brother. His name is Mike. The basketball is his, okay? You see, his name is Mike. The basketball is his. What does that mean? The basketball belongs to him, right? There are artists. Their paintings are great, okay? These paintings are theirs. Okay, questions with whose. Miren, eso es una palabra bien particular. Whose. Se las explico en español para que me entiendan bien. Who significa a quién le pertenece a alguien. Cuando oigan la palabra whose, lo que les están preguntando, a quién pertenece algo. ¿Verdad? Así de simple, así de simple. Quieren saber de quién es algo. ¿Ok? Whose dog is this? ¿De quién es el chucho? ¿Ok? Whose dog is this? Mine. It's mine. It's my dog. Whose keys are those? ¿Ok? ¿De quién son las llaves? Acuérdense. Whose. Whose keys are those? Hairs, their hairs, their hair keys. Okay, guys. Demonstrative pronouns, guys. ¿Y cuáles son los demonstrative pronouns? Que no hay que okay. Ya los habíamos visto, solo que hoy les ponemos así un nombre elegante, ¿verdad? Now we use, guys, an elegant names. But you already know, okay, what they are. These. This is singular, guys. This is singular, and it means something close at hand. These is plural, and it means, guys, something farther away. Something farther away. That, guys, is singular, and it means, guys, no, by the way, this means something close at hand. Okay, that means, guys, something farther away, but it is singular. Those mean something, things that are farther away, but they are plural. Near, these. Far, you see, guys, near, these. Far, that, those. That's what it means, okay? This is our neighborhood. These are his eyeglasses. Far, that is a cool place. Those are pictures of my family. Usage note. We contract that is that. But we do not contract other demonstrative with P verbs, okay? Demonstrative adjectives, okay, guys? Singular, plural, near, far. Okay. Oh, this man is our neighborhood. You see? These eyeglasses are here. Okay, are his. Far. This coffee shop is a cool place. Those pictures are of my family. You see? Those pictures are of my family. Ahora yo les hago una pregunta. ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre demonstrative adjectives y demonstrative pronouns? Esa es más una categoría gramatical. que yo podría dejarla así implícita, pero no creo que sea lo correcto. What is the difference, guys, between the demonstrative pronouns and the demonstrative adjectives? ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre los demonstrative adjectives and the demonstrative pronouns, guys? Pretty much it has to do, guys, with the function that they have. Tiene que ver con la función que ellos realizan en la oración. What is this, that, this, and those guys in these sentences? ¿Qué son ellos en estas oraciones? Veamos si se acuerdan las partes de las oraciones. ¿Se acordarán? Son, miren, sujeto. This is, that is, these are, those are. Son los sujetos de la oración. Y acuérdense que el sujeto de la oración siempre es un sustantivo. Y si no se usa sustantivo, se usa un pronombre. El pronombre, miren, viene de nouns. El pronombre sustituye al nombre. A pronoun, guys, replaces a noun. Okay? They function as nouns. Entonces, se fijan aquí, this, that, and this, están funcionando como pronombres. Están reemplazando un sustantivo. Y miren, aquí está la prueba, que podemos cambiarla. This is our neighborhood. ¿Cuál sería el noun que podríamos reemplazar? Carlos is our neighborhood. These are his eyeglasses. Okay. These things are his eyeglasses. Ya vieron que se puede sustituir por pronouns. We can replace it, guys, by nouns. Okay. That is a cool place. The park is a cool place. Those are pictures of my family. Those photos are pictures of my family. Por eso es que son pronouns, porque están reemplazando nombres. Pero y en este caso, ustedes, ¿quién me explica? This man, these eyeglasses, those pictures, that coffee shop. Y en este caso, ¿qué están haciendo? Aquí está la clave, miren. Adjectives. Los adjetivos solo hacen una función. They only have one function. What do? They modify nouns. They modify nouns. ¿Ellos qué hacen? Modifican sustantivos. Entonces, these, that, these, those, ¿qué están haciendo aquí? Modificando sustantivo. ¿Cuál? This man, este es el sustantivo que está modificando. Está diciendo este hombre que está cerquita. These eyeglasses, nos está modificando eyeglasses, que es un sustantivo. Estos lentes que están aquí cerquita. Those pictures, que están modificando, este es sustantivo. O sea, aquí no están trabajando como sujetos. Aquí están modificando sustantivos. So guys, I want you to keep, you see that difference in your mind, because it is kind of important. You must say, okay, that's not really like a big deal, but yes, on the long run, guys, in the long run, it will be, you know, important. A largo plazo es importante que notemos esa diferencia, por eso le estoy haciendo la aclaración. And now, guys, here comes, guys, the big deal. Yes, people. Yes, big deal, guys, okay? Fill in the blanks, guys, okay? I want you guys to get to page 25, la hora de la verdad, guys, okay? Now, this is the hour of truth, guys, okay? Okay, fill in the blanks, write the correct words, guys, okay? You have to do these exercises. This is exercise A, guys. And now, guys, I want you to do exercise B. Match the question and statement with the appropriate response, guys. So we match these questions with these responses that we have over here. Complete the passage, guys. Or the passage is this text that we have in here, guys. And take a look at the picture so that you get to have an idea what this paragraph is all about. Just by watching this, guys, I would say that it is a country in Asia. It could probably be India. No, guys, it is Cambodia, you see. A country in the far eastern, guys. In far eastern Asia. Now, you have to complete this text, guys, by using the words that we have in the rectangle. Okay, guys, do you think 10 minutes will be enough? ¿Creen que 10 minutos les alcance o necesitan más tiempo? Guys, do you think 10 minutes will be enough or you need more time? People, please tell me.
Yes.
Okay, guys, I'll give you 10 minutes, please. Okay, wonderful. I'll give you 10 minutes, guys. Go ahead, work it out. You can work it out. Life is very short, and there's no time for fussing and fighting, my friend. Okay, guys, please go ahead. Bueno, váyanse a la página 25 y ahí lo hacen. Ahorita ya, ya se los pongo en la pantalla, permítanme. Give me some time, guys. I just need to watch something. Okay, we have a writing. Most likely, we could finish this next week on Tuesday. Yes. And then we begin covering the new unit. Okay, good, 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 good. Okay, guys, go ahead. Have fun. And girls, just wanna have fun. Vamos a cantemos así como Cindy Lauper, guys. And the class just wants to have fun. Okay, guys? Have fun, people. Have fun.
Teacher, ¿la 25 o la 27?
Let me take a look at it. Déjame ver. Déjame ver. Y yes, así la 27, usted, it's 27. No sé, yo vi un 5 aquí, fíjate, pero es 7. I saw a 5, but it is a 7. Yeah, 27, 27, 27. Y les dejo ahí un videito para que piensen en la importancia de cuidar el medio ambiente. Good morning, teacher. Hoy no podré participar. Ok, Melvin. Jennifer, good morning, teacher. Good morning, Jennifer. Arlene, es que no escucho. Está bien, Arlene, no se preocupe. No se preocupe, Arlene.
Teacher.
Yes, tell me.
La página 25 no la hemos realizado. ¿Cuál vamos a hacer la 27?
Espérenme. No me equivoqué. Usted, yes. No me equivoqué.
Es 25.
Es la 25. Sí, es la 25. Es que me fui para abajo a ustedes para ver en cuántos días cubría estas cosas que nos faltan. Entonces sí me confundí. Pero lo que acabo de explicar es la 24, ¿verdad? Es lo que acabamos de explicar, la 24. Entonces, por lógica, tenemos que hacer la 25. Sí, la 25, ustedes. La 25, imagínense. Okay. Mi Alzheimer, ustedes. Mi Alzheimer, ustedes. That's my Alzheimer, guys. Ahí me van a ver al psiquiátrico cuando esté internado. Pobrecito, el viejito hay que irlo a ver. Ok, guys. I am good at speaking nonsense, guys. Okay, people, go ahead. Go, go, go. Have fun, guys. Have fun. Miren que la gramática era uno de mis temas favoritos. Cuando era estudiante todavía de física, agarraba libros de gramática en inglés y me iba al último piso de medicina. Abría las ventanas, me sentaba ahí en el suelo y empezaba a leer libros de gramática. Así que espero que les guste. La gramática es poderosa. It's powerful, guys. Grammar is really very powerful, guys. Okay. Okay, guys, you are full of life, guys. That's why you are happy and you must have fun with these exercises, people. Okay, we are full of life, guys. Full of life and we are happy. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it. ¿Se acuerdan del kinder? Ya se acordaron ustedes. No. No les cantaba esa canción en el kinder. Ok, Yesenia, no pude decir presente. Ajá, ya le vamos a hablar las orejas, Yesenia. No se preocupe. Ok, veamos, Yesenia, si le puse asistencia. Let me check here, Yesenia. Carla, Melvin, Miriam, Arlene, Yesenia. No le había puesto asistencia, ahorita se la ponemos. No le vamos a hablar muy duro en las orejas, no se preocupe. Ok, very good. You're welcome, Yesenia, you're welcome. A pleasure to help you. Ok, un placer ayudarles a todos ustedes. Para eso estamos aquí, para ayudarles. If you're happy and you know what, clap your hands. Yes, wonderful. Very good. Alguien me contestó finalmente. Bueno, dale. That cheers me up. Esto lo vamos a cantar. Yo, un día esto lo vamos a cantar. Y los voy a poner a moverse. No he querido hacer eso porque no los veo. Entonces, no sé si se van a mover o no se van a mover ustedes. Okay, guys. We will do this activity one day here. Seven minutes, people. 7 minutes. Seven minutes, people. Six minutes, people. 6 minutes. We have 6 minutes, people. Five minutes, people. 5 minutes. Five minutes, people. 5 minutes. Thank you. 4 minutes, people, 4 minutes. Minutes, people, 3 minutes. Concentrate, concentrate. Take it easy, guys. Slowly, but you got it right, guys. You got it right. Minutes, people, 2 minutes. Minutes, people, and we begin checking everything. How are you doing, guys? Do you need any help? Is it easy or difficult, guys? What is the level of difficulty, guys? Do you master it? Do you need any help? Okay, I don't know, people, I don't know. You tell me, guys, you let me know. Okay, guys, do we check it now, guys, or do you need more time? People, how are you doing, guys? Do we check the exercise now, people? People, answer me. Please say something. Something, teacher. Guys, do we check the exercises now? I'm making a question to you all, guys. Answer me. No puedo creerlo. ¿Me escuchan ustedes?
Yes, teacher.
Pero nadie me contesta. Ustedes, ¿cómo pueden ser tan crueles conmigo? Nobody loves me. I'm gonna cry. Okay, ¿lo revisamos ahorita o necesitan más tiempo?
No.
Yes, no. Okay, very good, very good. So let's check what we got, people. Okay, wonderful. Okay, fill in the blanks, write the correct words. Okay, Kate, parents are musicians. So what is number one, guys? Okay, what do we write? Number one, people.
Kate.
Very good. Kate's parents are musicians, okay? The second one, guys?
Her mother.
Her mother is a singer. And next?
Her father.
It's a guitar player, right? Okay, very good, people. What about number two, guys? Okay. Yes, number one. Number one and number two, guys. Number two, I. What do we write?
My.
My dad is rich. My dad is rich. And then?
His company is very big. Company is
very big. And then what goes next? Yes.
His owns the shop.
He, look, listen. He owns these shops. Ahí no hacemos ningún cambio. Ahí solo ponemos he, porque el verbo owns significa poseer. Él es dueño de estas tiendas. He owns these shops. Okay, guys. The plane is...
His.
His. Very good, very good. What about number three, guys? Sam. Guys, what about number three? Okay, number three. Sam is a great tennis player. And then, you begin.
His brother
played
tennis too.
Okay, very good. Mr. Hall is
their
coach. Very good, very good. Number four, guys. Rick and Pam are married. The cat is
theirs.
Theirs. Okay. And then, guys, what's next?
Yes.
What's next?
It's me.
Name is Blackie. That one, guys. Blackie, I like it like that. What about number five, people? There are 10 people in
our
family. Okay, yes, in our family. That big house is
ours.
That big house is ours. The car is too small for
us.
Fíjense, no hemos visto los direct objects y aquí les hacen trampa a ustedes. That car is too small for us. Sí, for us. Ahí sería OS, pero eso no lo hemos visto. Qué raro. Okay, number six, guys. Number six.
Yes.
This is Jeff's hotel. Yes. And then, guys.
Yeah.
And then, I'm sorry, what's next? What is next? This is Jeff's hotel.
He is nice to his.
He is nice to his guests. O sea que ahí no cambiamos el pronombre. We don't change the pronoun, guys. We leave it like that. He's nice to his guests. The guys, the... The people and then
the hotels
service is really good. Okay, guys, here are the answers in case you want to see them. We don't have the answers, guys. What do they mean by this? No, okay, finish. Wait a minute. Finish. Okay. No, okay. There are 10 people in our... Okay, for us, miren, aquí en vez, cabal. Un direct object están usando, pero eso no lo hemos visto todavía. Okay, anyway. People match the question statement with the appropriate response. Okay, guys, number one. Is this your dress?
What's the letter, guys?
H. Okay, yes.
Mine.
Yes, it's mine. Very good. Whose car is that? Number two, guys, whose car is that? What's the answer?
It's his.
Tell me the letter, guys. Tell me the letter.
It's
his. Very good, very good. Is that his family's farm? Number three?
Letter F.
Yeah, it's theirs.
It's theirs.
Okay. Where is the dog? Number four, people. Where is the dog? Number four.
Letter B.
It's the red one. Letter B. It's on its bed.
On the bed.
Yeah, it's on its bed. Very good. Is her guitar red, guys? Number five.
Yes, it's letter C.
It's letter the B? Red one. No, guys. It's on the bed. It's on. No, that's a dog, guys. That's a dog.
No. Hers
Where is the dog?
Blue one. No, hers is the blue one.
And what letter is for the
letter D?
No, okay, well, no. Okay, no, guys. Okay, no, hers is the blue one. D is for number five, guys. Yes, D is for number five.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah, D. Okay, is her guitar red? No, hers is the blue one. Okay, D is for number five. And G, and B, guys, is for number four. Okay, and that is a beautiful dog, guys. Okay, oh, yes. What about that one? Number six?
Letter A.
Letter A, yeah. It has a lovely big eyes. Very good, very good. Number seven. Which one is your bike? Bicycle. ¿Se acuerdan? Which is your big your bike? Which one is your bike?
Number seven.
It's a red one. Yeah, you got it right now. Very good, people. You see, we were wrong about it. What is your brother, people? Number eight. What's the letter?
Letter G.
He's
at school.
He has classes all day. Yeah, all day long. Now, complete the passage, people, okay? Use the words from the box to fill in the blanks. Okay, we got his, we have her, these, Jones, Jones, okay? In Cambodia's, it's her, words, hers. So, guys, it means that this one is repeated twice, okay? Guys, who wants to begin? Yo no quiero leer, ahora quiero que lean ustedes. Okay, guys. Please, you read, guys. I'm the one who has been doing the reading so far. Now it's your turn, guys. Now, you please help me out. Ay, ustedes me ayudan ahora. Quiet. Guys, who wants to begin?
Danny and...
Yes. Uh-huh. And...
Here.
Her parents...
Yes, your parents are in
Cambodia. Very good. Mire que la de él la convierte en ganar en los gringos. Cambodia. Okay, number two, guys. Number two.
Johannes.
Yeah, but read the complete sentence, guys. Pero lean toda la oración.
Her mother loves
to take photos.
Her mother loves to take
photos.
Okay, very good, very good. And number three, guys.
Her
camera is full
of great pictures.
Pictures, very good. Number four, guys, number four.
This photo of anger, what is?
Yes, is? Yes?
Her.
Okay, is, yeah, hers, very good. And anger, what is the number six?
Hers.
Angkor, why is the what is the number six, guys? Number
worst.
Six.
Worst.
The worst, yeah, the worst, biggest it's temple. Anchor. Okay, number seven.
Eret.
Number seven. I'm sorry.
It.
Its walls are strong. Pero léanme toda la oración ustedes. What about number eight, guys? What about number eight, people? Number eight, guys. People, number eight. What about number eight?
These walls are.
Yes. Yes. These walls are 3,600 meters long. 3,600 meters long. The tallest tower is 65 meters high. And for what is? Number nine,
Cambodia's
most
famous place.
Famous place. Number 10, guys. Number 10.
Cambodia.
Yes, guys. I'm sorry.
Her father.
Yeah, her father is in a store in the temple. He is happy with 11. With?
His new shirt.
His new shirt. Number 12 is a great vacation. No, gracias. Number 12. I'm sorry, guys. The vendor is announcing me what she said, so I'm saying no. Okay, people, number 12. Number 12. It's a great vacation. People, what do we write here? Take a look, guys. Take a look. Take a look, guys. What goes here? Take a look at the screen and read it aloud.
Díganlo, yeah. Díganlo.
Yeah.
It's a great vacation.
Yeah, it's a great application. Very good. Now, guys, we have a reading to do here. Do we still have time? Yeah, we kind of have some time, guys. Let me check. Let me check. Okay. No, guys, I don't think we're going to make it. We only have 10 minutes. No, I don't think we're going to make it. We only have less, almost 10 minutes, guys. No. We're not going to make it. Okay. Okay. So, guys. Okay. We will do one exercise, guys. Okay, let us do one activity, guys. Let us do one activity. Okay. Yes. This is what we will be doing. Okay. Give me a second. Say a color pink, as you still have to mention something whose main characteristic is color, I say. Okay, guys. Let us make, guys, a list of colors. That's what we will be doing. Okay. What colors do you know, guys? Like, I have written here, guys, some colors. Okay. Yeah, I know you have studied colors already, guys. Okay. Wait a minute. Let me present this for you here, guys. Okay. Okay, people. Warm up, practicing colors. Okay. I say a color: pink, red, blue, purple, orange, yellow. What colors am I missing, guys? Yes.
Black.
Sorry.
White. Black. White.
Brown.
Black.
Let me know. White. Brown. Wait, wait, wait.
Brown.
White. Brown. Another one.
Brown. Brown.
Okay. Brown. Okay. What else, guys?
Green.
Gray.
Green. A minute, guys. Give me some time.
Gray.
Gray. Are we missing anything?
Gold.
Else?
Gold. Yes. Still
gold.
There.
Gold.
Okay,
very good. Gold.
They.
Silver. Silver. What else?
Light blue.
Light. Beige. Light blue. Another one.
Beige.
Beige. I don't know what color that is, guys. I thought it was gray. Beige. What else? I think pretty much that's all.
Light green.
Turquoise.
Turquoise. Turquoise. And what color is that one?
Turquoise.
¿Color es ese usted?
Turquesa.
Es turquesa.
Yo no sé cuál es turquesa. Yo no sé cuál es el turquesa. A mí me parece
un
que
celeste morado, verde.
Celeste verde. A mí me suena morado. O sea, ah, vaya. Es que fíjense que sí, yo me puedo los colores esos, pero en el círculo cromático, en el color, guys. Aquí lo tengo, ¿eh? Yo no sé si se los puse la vez pasada. Me lo puedo en el color wheel. En el color wheel que existe en inglés y en español. But guys, sometimes they get to have it, have you see, guys, other names, but I don't really know what those names are. I don't really know what those names are, okay? Now, guys, you have to mention something whose main characteristic is a color, I say. Now, guys, I want you to think about something that has these colors, guys. Think about something that, you know, you see it and then you automatically know that it's got one of these colors. Okay, guys, make a list. Next to each color, right, guys, something whose main characteristic is one of the colors that we have here. Okay, guys, go ahead. I give you 3 minutes, people. No, 6 minutes. I give you 5 minutes, guys. Please write a word, guys, the name of an object whose main characteristic is the color. Okay. It's one of the colors that we have here, guys. Please complete the list. Complete the list. For example, guys, green. What is green, guys? Grass. Grass, lagama. But that is green. Okay. What else, people? What else?
Thank you.
You keep doing the same, guys. You keep doing the same.
¿Qué vamos a hacer, teacher?
Ah, bueno, que piensen en un objeto que tenga como característica principal
el color.
Colores. Por ejemplo, aquí puse a la par de green, escribí grass.
Grass.
Porque es la característica de la grama o el zacate, es que es verde.
Es verde.
Ajá. Ahora, now think about something that it is pink, something that it is red, something that okay. it is blood. Y ahí lo escriben a la par de la lista. Yes.
Gracias.
Yeah, it's okay, it's okay. There we go, there we go. Yes. Those are the directions, okay. Hey guys, there you go. Think about it, guys. Think about it. If you don't know it, guys, you find it out. Find out about it, right? Turquoise, turquoise, déjenme buscar este color. Vamos a ver si es verdad. Let me look for this color, guys. Turquoise. What color is this one, guys? I have no idea. Turquoise. It does not come to my mind. Cabal, miren la compañerita dice. Es un celeste como con. Como. Yo lo veo light. Pero sí, como que tuviera un poco de amarillo o verde, tienes razón.
Yeah.
I don't know, guys. It is like kind of green. It is between, guys. It would be a light blue mixed with a kind of green, guys. Okay? Turquoise. Turquoise. It probably comes from French, guys. Probably that is a French word, guys. Y lo más probable es que sea una palabra francesa. Most likely, guys, this is a French word, you see. It has been coined by the English language, you see. Yeah, 60% of the words in English, guys, belong to the French language, you see. That's what I have read, guys. That's what I have read, and that's what I understand about it. Okay, people, what is pink? Mention something that it is pink, guys. Pink?
Panther pink.
Yeah, pink.
Pink. Lips?
Wait a minute. Yeah, wait a minute. Pink.
Pink panther.
Pink panther. Also lips, right? Yeah, if you dye them with this color, right? What else, people? What else is pink?
Cotton candy.
You're what? I'm sorry? What was that?
Cotton candy.
Candy? Yeah, some candies are pink. Yeah, it might be. What else, guys? What else? Oh, your bedroom. Your bedroom is pink. Yes, that's because you are a girl, right? Yeah, that's because you're a girl. Okay, what else, people? I'm sorry? What is
The shirt.
Shirts, yes, some shirts, flowers, but what flower, my friend? Can you be more specific?
How do you say roses?
Roses, oh yeah, some roses are pink, okay. Red, guys, what is red?
Apples,
yes, what else?
Blue.
Sorry. Guys, you always speak at the same time and you get me confused. I'm sorry. Say it again.
Heart.
Blood.
You mean
lip.
I'm sorry. Guys?
Heart.
I would say blood. I would say blood. What else would you say, guys? People? Red?
Hair.
Hair.
Well, if you dye it hair, if you dye it red, then it is red.
The blue. Look,
guys.
The ocean.
Sky.
Ocean. The sky. What else? Blue?
Jeans.
Jeans. Okay, that's why.
Car.
Well, not all of them, right? Only blue jeans. Purple people. Purple.
The grapes.
Barney dinosaur.
I'm sorry.
Barney the dinosaur.
Oh, the dinosaur. Barney. Yeah, the dinosaur. Barney the dinosaur. Okay, very. He was purple, guys. I don't remember. Okay, the dinosaur. Orange, guys. What is
the horizon?
Orange.
Orange.
What?
Orange.
An orange. An orange. It's orange. Okay.
Tangerine.
Tangerine.
The sunset.
Tangerine.
Tangerine.
Okay, very good.
People,
what is yellow? What did you say, guys?
Sun.
Okay. What is, guys, black?
Dark.
Night.
Dead.
Okay. At Shadow. Night, guys. At night.
Banana.
At night, guys. Yeah, bananas are also yellow. That's very good. Okay, guys. We have to finish the class here, people. It is already 7:50. Okay. And we will probably finish this activity tomorrow, guys. Okay. I don't know. Do you have any questions before we finish, guys? Before I say goodbye, do you have any questions?
No, teacher. Goodbye.
No questions.
Bye, teacher.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye. See you
tomorrow.
Bye.
Oh, yes.